we welcome you all on this global platform that to discuss about how the challenges are in the COVID times, how we are struggling, how we are trying to become a role model in our countries. This program is from ASMP Sudan chapter, which is very much supported by EWGE, that which is founded by Wafat Alha in Sudan, and for the youths to empower them, to build their capacity, to bring them to the new world through the technology and all. So this is all a brief about our initiative. We keep doing this kind of programs across Africa, across other part of the world, to empower youths, to motivate youths to come on the platform and use their own talent and demonstrate to others, so they can also achieve certain goal and be the successful man in their own life. Thank you so much for joining today. So today I'll just bring Wafa first to introduce all those participants today. They are in this live show, and she will just pick one of them, that at least from which part of the Sudan, so we can start our discussion today. Wafa, please.
Okay, welcome my friends. Assalamu alaikum. Marhaba fi ASMP. Welcome in ASMP India.
Welcome.
ASMB chapter. Inshallah, hanabda al-liqa bita'na min this platform مع دكتور شاهد. كل واحد فيكم, أنا بتمنى كل واحد فيكم يعرف نفسه والريجن بتاعه. We have like 7 members from different regions from Sudan. We have from Darfur region and Eastern region and also Central region and Khartoum. And we have one from Kordofan state. Welcome Mr. Mahmoud and his daughter Tawa. And we want you to introduce yourself and Tawa and what she's doing and business. And also after you finish from your talk, Mr. Anwar, he will do the translation. He's your interpreter right now.
Assalamu alaikum.
Assalamu alaikum. Wa alaikum assalam.
Dr. Shahid, how are you?
I'm good.
My name is Mahmoud Haj Taha. I'm from Omdurman, Sudan. My daughter is Taqwa. She's near me here. She's born, I think they call them the Mongolese. She is born in UAE, Abu Dhabi. We are found there. Very good doctor. She's fortunately she's a Sudanese, and she started with her since she's born, and she teach her so many things, talking, her memory. I believe so many things she's done very well for her. She studied there from beginning in the UAE. I've been school there. After that, we are came to Sudan, and she start with the center here. School, we are call it the future center for them. And she is very well. She like to to know everything. Whatever she see, she will be very perfect for that thing. And she start to do this accessories for buying from Drumman market, and she's doing it herself. She can show you what she's doing. This is what she's do herself.
Okay, very beautiful.
We are aware, they are call us, they invite us for so many universities and Khartoum channel, so many TV channels, Khartoum channels. Wherever they call us, I used to take her there. Since we have started this before 2 years, really now she is perfect. She can talk very well. She is connected with the others very well. I don't know, my English time is okay, or I supposed to?
Yeah, you speaking well.
Yeah, it's okay. I like it. Well. Yes, go ahead.
Unfortunately, more than 14 years, I didn't talk in this language.
Very good. Yeah,
my God, very nice.
I know even some little word in Urdu, but unfortunately, I forgot all that.
No.
No problem. Go ahead.
We understand everything.
Everything as well.
And I'm happy to you understand what I'm saying. Because a long time I didn't use this language, but that I can't follow. But fortunately,
go ahead. You're doing well.
Anyway, now, alhamdulillah, wherever they call us, I used to keep everything and go with her.
Bernard.
They are very clever. They are very smart. Whatever she sees, she can do it very well, better than so many others. Fortunately,
this is why she is here. Because she's unique, this why she is here. لأنها مميزة تغوى عشان كده هي معانا هنا.
That's
which
I like.
Yes, yes.
Wherever they call us, they invite
Definitely
us.
Definitely, that was the reason.
Yeah. I never reject any invitement for anywhere I used to go. And
I have one question here. I have one question here with from you. That how because she's so bright, so innovative, so creative. How the situation is now in this lockdown or in this kind of corona phase where all the markets are shut down, there are very limited buyers, there are limited marketplace. How the situation is now for her?
The main thing for her, it's not for a fund or something like that. It's not for the money. Actually, I used to buy so many things for her from the market. I used to give her. She's doing it wherever we are going to the any exhibition or to any invitement for anywhere. She is selling. Whatever she is selling, so many times she is giving a gift without any money. Again, I used to buy from my own pocket. I never run for the to gain anything. Just I need her how to deal with the others, how to talk properly with the others, how to enjoy with them. This is my this is my plan for her.
Okay.
To talk with the other very well, to understand what the people are saying, and she is connect very well with them. This is which I need. It's not the money. Money is the last thing I'm thinking to gain from this sense. I used to buy.
Let Anwar do this for him because I don't think he get the question. Anwar.
Okay. Anwar, please.
Yeah, I said.
Speak in Arabic, Anwar. Translate Dr. Shahid's question to him.
الدكتور قال لك يعني في ظل الكورونا اللي حاصلة دي والقفل اللي حاصلة في البلد الأمور ماشية معاها كيف هناك وخططك شنو معاها للمستقبل؟
This the market is open actually. We are used to buy so many things for her. She's at the time of this COVID-19, she's just working in home. She done so many things, so many new things, and she liked it because just luckily we are going to Khartoum International Exhibition. They are call us for 7 days and she's finishing everything. People that used to come in Sudan here. COVID-19 is not that much like the other world, or like the other countries.
So we can take another participant, you know, that to introduce, and then we can proceed further. Again, we'll be back to Asma again once the network is good. So,
thank you, Dr. Shahid. Right now, we can go to Darfur region. There is Walid and Najla. She's the businesswoman there. Okay. Brother Walid. لو سمحت انت ونجد عرفوا روحكم ومنطقتكم اجيتوا منها بالإضافة للمشروع بتاعكم Let us hear what Dr. Shahid will say to you. خلينا نسمع يقول لكم شنو
السلام عليكم
عليكم السلام
So
it's good to see you here and we want to hear from you how the things have changed for you both as a businessman because we are struggling all over the world so I just want to hear and start your discussion that how the things have changed for you now.
Anwar, ممكن تترجم السؤال اليوم.
Okay. I'm Walid Yaqub from North Darfur State in Al-Fashir City, and my colleague is me.
Najla Abdullah Muhammad Idris.
Najla Abdullah. Yeah, she's worked for the recycle. The garbage of the home, and she make the good things about this recycle. He converted this recycle home recycle to the pilot things. I think he reduces the polluted environment, such as the remain of bottles, remain of dishes, and tires, something like this.
اوكي نجلاء اذا عندك حاجه عاوزه تضيفيها ممكن تتكلمي بالعربي انور ركز عشان تترجم ليها
اوكي عندك
نجلاء if you want to add anything you can add it انور he is here for you
نعم انا بديت اعمالي من 2005 كنت بشتغل في شغل اللاساتيك لاحظ ما في نت بعد ما جات النت اتطورت الشغل وانا كنت ما عارفه اتواصل كيف مع الناس اساس انه اطور عملي فاشتغلت في شغل الخرس بشتغل شيالات واطقم مكتبيه من اعمال الخرس بالاضافه لشغلي بتاعت الاكسسوري بصمم بطريقتي الخاصه ما قرت لها اي كورس ولا اخذت فيها دوره تدريبيه خالص ركزت الآن في شغل اللاساتيك وعلب الصلصة الفارخة بشتغل لأناتيك والقوارير بالإضافة لجزء من اللوحات اللي هي المكسرة بعيد صيانتها تاني بشتغل بالسكسوك الناعم والخرس والجليتر بالإضافة للعلب بتاعنا البشرة برضو قاعدة أشتغل فيها بالإضافة للورق اشتغلت منها مجموعة أشياء برضها لوحات خائطية من الورق الكوبايات الفارغة بتاعت الورق اللي بتكون يعني استخدامها مرة واحدة بيدعوها ما بنستفيد منها اشتغلت منها يونيتات حائطية من الكوبايات الفارغة دي بالإضافة للأطباق حقنا البيض اشتغلت منها أسقف مستعارة واشتغلت منها مقاعد للمنزل يعني دي أعمالي أنا شغالة بيها من 2005 بداية فكرة العمل حقي فبعد ما جات النت اتطورت الشغل والحمد لله أنا يعني ماشي في شغل متطور شوية لساتي كان زمان بنضرب بوهية الآن عندي شغل شغالة فيها يا داب جبت اللساتي جمعتها غسلتها نظفتها بعد شنو جات المرحلة بتاعت التنجيد بننجدها ونعملها كراسي دباديب بطريقة سمحة إن شاء الله
أنور
نعم والأكياس أيضا الأكياس برضو يعني بنشتغل فيها بدل ما إنه الحاجة دي نحن ندفقها باللويس بتعمل لنا تلويس بيئي بتعمل لنا مشاكل كثيرة بالأخص البهايم الأكياس بيتناولوها أكثر شيء البهايم الغنم يعني فبالتالي دي بتكون لنا مشكلة كبيرة أعيق في حياتنا نحن عشان ما نقطع الحياة دي يا جماعة بيجينا شنو نلمها ونستفيد منها الزجاجة لو قدحتها في الكوشة أورد شنو بيجرح ليزول بيعوك ليزول بيسبب مجموعة حاجات فحتى الزجاجة المكسرة المرايات المكسرة بنجمعها بنعمل منها لوحات حائطية ولفظة جلالة نعم
شكرا لك Hello? شكرا thank you so much okay I can do it instead of Anwar Najla from North Darfur she said my project is recycling the garbage the home garbage and also I'm using the tire for the cars I change it to seats and some cushion, some seats and sofas at home. And after that, I can use the tomato sauce container to change it to faza for the flowers. And also, she using all the plastic to fill the cushion to make it for the home for the sofas and the chairs. And also she's against the environment pollution. She's always helping the environment to be healthy. And she's trying to use all the empty bottles, all the empty containers, everything at home to change it to something beautiful because she thinks she's friend with her community and she's helping. And she said, before I never got trained for this, it's just a hope and this is my talent. And she said the internet not available in my areas. I cannot follow anything about the recycling globally. I'm doing this just from my I'm taking all this from my environment, from the community around me. And after the internet became available in her area, she started following others, and she started following how the people outside doing using the recycling, how they convert it to something useful. And she said, I try to train myself, is self-training, self-education for herself. And right now she's trying to improve her business, and she's trying to improve her work. And she will keep working with the recycling, and she will improve her work. And she's trying to be something, she's trying to keep her work to be something beautiful. And this kind of talk she's mentioned, I'm sorry if I missed anything from your talk, because I wasn't doing Anwar, we missed Anwar in the last moment. Thank you, Najla. Shukran, Najla, from Darfur. Thank you so much.
So I guess facing a weak internet here. So
Anwar, I did it instead of you.
Really, not sorry.
Thank you. Shukran. أنا قمت به لكن ما زيك أنت ما بأكمل وجه. إن شاء الله حنتلاقى في الميتنج الثاني.
So we can ask one question, that how she is, you know, connected to the different part of the world. Is she using the social media, or that is not available there?
Okay, Najla, السؤال لك يا نجلاء.
نجلاء مرحبا.
السؤال لك يا نجلاء إنه أنت قبل كده قبل واو إلكتريسيتي هي.
Hello.
نجلاء, you can hear me.
أنا قاعد مرحبا. أيوة.
السؤال إنه
أنت. أنا بعرف حاجة عن طريق ال.
أها. إنه أنت قبليها ما كان في إنترنت في المنطقة بتاعتكم, وما قادرة تطور الشغل بتاعك, وما قادرة تعرفي الحاصل شنو في العالم برا globally. لكن بعد ما جاء الإنترنت قدرتي تعرفي وتواصلي. بيسألك إنه كيف قدرتي. أي نوع من المنصات الإلكترونية أنت بقيتي عليها, يعني سوشيال ميديا, بتفتشي براكي, شنو قدرتي تصلي به للناس عشان تطوري حاجاتك دي. Okay, right now we can welcome Asma again from Eastern region, from Gadarif State, which the connection is good in your area. Asma, welcome. Asma, assalamu alaikum. Asma,
alaikum salam. Hi,
hello Asma.
Is it good now?
Yeah, this is much better. So we wanted to ask you several, two times we failed to ask one question, that which part you are from, Sudan, and how you are dealing with this kind of crisis situation, especially in the pandemic whole world is going through. How you are dealing there, being an activist, being a creative person or innovative person?
Okay, hi, I am Asma Hamza. I represent Al Gadarif State. In fact, I tried to buy enough materials because I couldn't be able to find all the things or the materials that I need because of definitely, you know, marketing closing abroad and exporting stuff from China and from Egypt. I guess these are the two countries that all or most of the material that I use, they in fact, they exported from these countries, and they were closed down because of the pandemic. So I bought a big amount, a lot amount of my materials, and I started working. In fact, I was actually getting benefit of YouTube in several channels. They were really helping me a lot to find new ideas and new design, and to be updated with the new materials, how they do use it, and to start you know, connecting different ideas with each other to create new products. In fact, I was facing a problem of lack of some materials, but I turned into another handmade products, such as papers, using papers. And paper flower.
Yeah, please go ahead.
Hello, can
continue.
Yeah, I'm listening.
Yeah,
continue.
About the pandemic, I was starting from home working and you know, getting benefit of YouTube. It was the main facility that was available for me.
So how you promote your products now? Because now you told that you had the material in advance, you wanted to do all the kind of things, you know, in advance, that before the lockdown. It is very slow down. It's not very effective in other places as well. So how you are dealing with this situation?
Sorry, I didn't catch the last word.
Yeah, I'm telling you, in this crisis of this pandemic, where all the things are, you know, shut down, the markets are online, your internet is not working there too much. It's very difficult to stable the internet connection or something. So how you are dealing this kind of situation? Because now everything has shifted to the digital. So nobody is working physically in other part of the world.
In fact, I was dealing with the market. I took their numbers. I was dealing with them with WhatsApp. They sent me their products, their materials, and I actually asked my sister. She is in Khartoum. She could have the material, and she transported for me in Gadarif. If there is someone really coming by car, because the early stage of locking down was the buses were not, you know, were not working the transportation, but now it's available. We can have our materials, and it's also available right now. But before a few months, it was difficult, but right now it's pretty much easier.
So how you do you train other youngsters also, like what you are doing? Do you have other people that those who learn from you and become successful like you? Is there any case?
اسمع well, سؤالك انت بعدتي منه شديد الاجابه بتاعته بعدتي منه شديد السؤال انه السؤال حاليا انه في ناس قدرت تتعلم الحاجه اللي انت الاسي شغالاها دي قدرت تتعلمي ناس ثانيين حاسه انه الناس ممكن تقدر تستفيد منها سوري دكتور شهد I guess translate
In fact I have my nephew at home she was helping me I couldn't really reach anyone until now to be working with someone or any organization to try to learn someone or learn from anyone. Actually, I was contacting with Dr. Wafa to have this opportunity to have someone to learn with or some, you know, to start to try to find a team or someone who has the same passion, so we could teach these people or try to learn from them and teach them the skills. I was searching about people like this. Until now, I couldn't find. In fact.
Yeah, can you show me any sample that you have, some of your design that we can see, everybody can see here?
Okay. Well, I have this. This is a handmade bag.
Yeah.
In fact, I used different materials and I stitched it by myself, in fact.
Okay.
Is it shows?
Yeah, it's very beautiful. Yeah.
Yeah. Okay. And I have this. It's wall hang. Mm-hmm. In fact.
Okay.
Okay. Using burlap and sticks. Okay, wooden sticks. And I have sandals. I got this.
Yeah.
This is also, yeah.
Yeah,
but
so this is all handmade. These are all handmade.
Yeah, all are handmade. Did them by myself. In fact, I was depending on YouTube the most to see the different level of how to do sandals or bags, and I followed their steps and. Yeah, that's what I.
It's very nice. Yeah, so it's very nice product. I can guarantee you, Wafa will guide you in further, because we are planning to bring all the youths across the world, those who are talented, those who have some capacity to explore the different part of the world. So we are connected in 28 countries across the world. So once we are at this platform, definitely we can bring your product to the different market, because everybody is watching through this. This is live show. It is going on Facebook. There is live on the page. This will be again on the YouTube. It will be live. So this will create a new market for you. And we want that, you know, you join hand with Wafa at the local level. They are working very hard. And she is leading the ASMP chapter of Sudan. And she has her own organization, EWGE, which is really, really very, very hardworking people and team. They are exploring new avenues. So definitely we'll talk with you. And it's really beautiful. I can see the prospects. You know, we can bring your product to the different part of the world. We can bring the customer for you. We can help you to promote. We can use the social media tools, how to promote your product, how to create your video, you know, to motivate others across the world. So really, it's really very, very encouraging for us. And we really look forward to it. And we'll again talk. So we just want to have next participants. If Wafa can call by the name, that we can start and discuss with him also.
Okay. Thank you, Asma. Shukran shadeed, Asma.
Thanks a lot. Thank you so for having this opportunity. Okay.
Thank you so much. Right now, we can move to Nahid and Ghazi. And Ghazi represents a business. He can discuss his business and he can introduce what he's doing. غازي مرحبا بك يا غازي انت وناهد يا ريت تورونا انتم شغالين شنو والمشروع بتاعكم
يا انميوت بليز انميوت
يا جماعه اقفلوا الصوت النغمه الشغاله دي اقفلوا الصوت اسمع اقفل الصوت بتاعك
اوكي
خلوا الفيديو شغال اقفلوا الصوت غازي غازي جماعة في زول شغال الصوت بتاعه يا أنور يا مروة ناهد أقفلوا الصوت بتاعكم مروة سارة أقفلوا الصوت بتاعكم يا مروة
I see it's okay now.
Yes. So, Wafa, we can start with some other participants.
I'm just speaking to her. She's not responding.
Okay, so we can take another participant. So, till the time she will be back, we can take it up.
Okay. Ghazi. I'm just going.
Somebody's not hearing well because of network. It's
okay.
So
yeah, we're calling Ghazi and Nahid, Dr. Shahid.
Yeah.
Right now, there is Ghazi and Nahid from Khartoum State.
Yeah, welcome Nahid and Ghazi.
Nahid and Ghazi.
Okay.
Okay, I think he's not here. We can move to what's her name? Marwa. She's a businesswoman. She's designing Sudanese top like sari, Dr. Shahid. Oh.
Okay.
Yeah. Marwa.
Hello.
They are here. Marwa.
Yeah.
Yes, yes.
Assalamu yes, come alaikum. Close, Marwa. Open the. After his thought, yeah, Marwa. Khalik Gariba. Yes.
Fatih.
Yeah, from Khartoum State, there is Marwa. She's businesswoman. She's designing Sudanese top. And she has many products. Right now, she can introduce herself and her business. Marhab Marwa. Marwa min al Khartoum. Hiya Sudanese musammima al thiyab. Marwa, arif lana al business bitaik.
Hello.
Hello, how are you?
Hello.
Yes. Yes, please tell me about yourself, that how you are doing and how you are motivating other people with your designs.
اتكلمي عن نفسك وورينا انه انت البيزنس بتاعك شنو وكيف انت نميتي البيزنس بتاعك وبتقدري تشتغلي فيه.
My name is Marwa Said from Sudan. Born in 90, I studied fine arts at the University of Sudan in 2012. I started training and rehabilitating people with special needs and the handbit at Afad University. For women, and in 2014, I worked in the training of village children in my town, the popular neighborhood.
Okay, Dr. Shahid, she has interpreter. Sarah, you can introduce yourself and business. Yeah. Marwa's. Come. Come to the video.
Hello, Marwa. How are you? Sarah.
I think the connection not that good. Sarah.
Yeah, network is very bad. So that. Yeah.
They are in Khartoum. I don't know.
The issue of network. Doctor.
Yeah, no issue. So we can talk with other friends, you know, that we were talking to the sir in the in the beginning with the Tagwa, that how she, her design we wanted to see, her design that what she has created, how they are doing, that if he can show us on this screen, then it will be very good. That how...
Yeah, Mahmoud, مع
تقوى. يا محمود السلام عليكم.
دايرك توريه الشغل بتاع تقوى.
محمود تقوى. هاي ارفع لنا حاجات كده شوفها عشان نشوفها الدكتور. من شغل تقوى اللي اشتغلته.
الصوت افتح الصوت يا عم محمود.
جيب الحاجات قريب افتح الصوت وورينا الحاجات.
افتح الصوت يا عم محمود.
كده واضح؟
ايوه
اوكي
ايوه واضح. ورينا الحاجات اللي اشتغلتها تقوى.
اوكي
قريب على الكاميرا.
This what she is doing.
This is necklace.
This is the
yeah.
The hands. And this for the ears.
Okay.
Yeah, earrings.
Okay, again, then...
Give the magic, Tanya.
Sure, this one.
Diamonds, this or what?
Also, she wearing something good in her hand.
Yeah.
Yeah, of course.
This is what she's wearing. She's done this herself. This is in her right hand.
Good. Okay. قربهم للكاميرا شوية.
all the things that is made by her.
Actually, and there's so many things. This is also for the. This is what she's done, which she's wearing now.
Wow.
Yeah, nice.
Yes.
Okay.
So you see, Dr. Shahid, it's only for women. Why don't you have for the men, for us?
No, unfortunately, she's using. She's doing this for. Women and children.
Okay.
Like this.
Good. Nice.
Yeah.
Yeah, I like it.
She's doing also.
Very nice.
Yeah.
Yeah. Earrings.
Yeah.
Earrings, yes.
Yeah.
Good.
There's so many things she's doing, but it's so many designs. Unfortunately, I can't show all that.
Yeah.
This is what
she's doing.
Yeah, that is nice.
By herself. هي بتعمل الحاجات دي كلها براها من غير أي مساعدة without any assistant from anyone.
Actually, she got her own mobile and she's to get the full benefit from YouTube. Mm-hmm. Whatever she's saying, if we are repeated 2-3 times, really she's used to do it perfectly. I used to take her to the market. She's choosing whatever she like and we are come to the house, she's doing it. If there is so many expression, she will be very happy and she will be very active and do it very quickly. If there is no any expression, unfortunately, she will be very lazy. She is not doing anything. It's the expression is
oh
the
hard
little push to do this thing. But if during this corona,
be creative, yes.
Unfortunately, she is not doing anything. We are asking her to do something, but she refused to do anything. If we are tell her there is an expression, she will be very active and doing whatever we are asking her.
Very nice. Very nice. So how you sell these kind of things? Are you using the marketplace or something that through Facebook, WhatsApp? How you are dealing? Because anyway,
يا يا محمود بيسوي الحاجات دي بيسويوها كيف بتتباع كيف عن اي طريقه بتبيعوا الحاجات دي وبيسويوها هل بتستخدموا الفيسبوك ولا اليوتيوب ولا تويتر ولا السوشيال ميديا كيف ولا عندكم ناس بيجوا بيشيلوا منكم في السوق ولا بتوديها انت السوق ليها هناك تسويها لها ولا كيف بتبيعوها كيف
شي got a page in the Facebook تقوى art products. Anybody, the people that used to see it and they're asking us to send to them. But we are telling them just we are going to the exhibition. If you are following her page, you will get, you will know when and where she will be.
Okay.
But now there are so many places in the market, they're asked us to bring her product. To sell it, and Umdurman, a great market, and there is so many places in Khartoum and in Bahri also, Khartoum Bahri. They are asking us to bring Dawa products for sale. I think it will be better for her if anybody's asked, sent an email to us and asking something. Just we will tell him. We are asking where he is stay, and we tell him the nearest place for him, if it's in Bahri or Khartoum or Umdurman.
Yeah, definitely we'll now offer, we'll help you out, how to promote, because we are taking everyone's talent here, we are noting down, because she has selected all the people, those who are really very deserving, have the potential to explore the world. So we are going to work in a second phase that how we can help Tagwa to explore the market by her own. It should not be with the middleman. Otherwise, she will not get the potential what she deserves. So that is what we are looking for. We will train her. We will train you. Even with Asma, the same situation, we will help her to bring to the different world platform. There are lots of platforms with the Amazon, with the Flipkart. You can have your own account. You don't need to have somebody else's account or something. So we'll train on that, how to explore the different thing. Because you have the talent, you can explore. And just this is like a matter of time that how to deal with the situation. And this is the right time to push the digital and to work on the social media tools. That is why we are working and bringing all the youths at one platform, that how you can use the best. So thank you so much. We'll again come to Marwa. Marwa, we missed you due to bad network, and we come back again, you know, to know about your design and how you are helping other youths to work like you and get success like you.
شكراً عم محمود. حيرجعوا لك تاني السؤال لمروة. حنرجع لك تاني يا مروة. سارة سارة أتعرف روحها وتتكلم تجاوب على السؤال اللي قاله دكتور شاهد هسه. سارة.
Yes. Hi, I'm Sarah. I'm from Sudan. Okay. Right now.
سارة خلي الكاميرا عليك يا سارة. إخواننا أضبطوا الكاميرا, خلي الكاميرا عليك. أوكي. أها. سمعتي السؤال بتاع دكتور شاهد يا سارة؟
No, no, no.
Okay. No. Can you please, دكتور شاهد, repeat the question for Marwa?
Yeah.
Focus يا سارة.
Yes, yeah, sir, can you tell me about yourself, what you are doing and how the things are changed for you in this kind of crisis where there is no market, physical market is not there, but online markets are there. How you are dealing with that and what kind of design you are having?
She has a lot of designer and creative top in Sudan, designer in Sudan. Okay. She famous so much and it depends of internet, social media on Instagram. And Facebook, and she has a location at Khartoum. Okay, she knows everyone, Marwa, and connected with other with telephone and like public figures. Okay, in Sudan, and she has a lot of work at home. Okay, and she donation some target of people because of COVID-19, the some of the women to increase income. She donation all these women of target and training popular neighborhood training, Marwa.
Okay.
Excuse me. يا مروة يا سارة عرفي روحك على سنك, انت المترجم بتاع مروة وهي شغالة شنو وجزء من التصميم بتاعه في اثناء اللوك داون هنا اتعاملت كيف مع البزنس بتاعك ساعدت اللي حوالينك. اقفل التليفون الكتره يا مروة, يا اقفل التليفون.
اوكي انا صورتي ليوه.
خلي الكاميرا عندك عديل, يعني انت خلي عديل. ايوه وكده انا انك انت ساره انت المترجمه بتاعت مروة كلام كامل. انت هي شغاله شنو ورد جزء بتاع شغلها وقدرت تساعدت كيف غيرها. اوكي يو كان سبيك رايت ناو ان انجلش مروة. ساره.
اوكي هالو.
يا وي كان هير يو.
يا ام ساره, ام ترانسليت فروم مروة. اوكي شي هاز ا لوت اوف ثينك هير. كان اي يوز ذس وان؟ I can show.
Yeah, please.
Okay. This like sare. This designer for Marwa.
Okay, very good.
Okay, and different design like African
back.
Already. This is all.
The scarf. Sari.
Yes.
Then stop.
Letters. This is the letters and the store.
Painting.
And this painting. The different design. This drops on top. Brand.
Thank you.
Yes, is it painting? This is the light. It's painting. The different designer. And this handmade bag, different materials. Fresh. And this is scarf. And the card, and this material said Moria, called Moria. You see, this is an African designer.
Okay, very beautiful.
سارة كيف مروة شغالة البيزنس بتاعها؟ هي قالت أمس كلام جميل إنه كانت هي بتشتغل وبتدرب بتشتغل هي وبتفتح مشاغل في المناطق الطرفية عشان النساء الفقيرات يشتغلوا كده. هي كيف بدأت تعمل الحاجات دي وكيف قدرت في أثناء اللوك داون إنه تواصل البيزنس بتاعها؟
طيب أنا بديت في الأحياء الشعبية
أول الأحياء المتطرفة. دقيقة يا مروة. دقيقة مرة. دكتور شاهين.
Yes.
Yeah. She started. You want to explain how she's doing her business and how she is helping the poor women in part of the cities, in the rural areas, and how she is helping them to start their own business like her and how they can earn money, daily money. This is what she's want to say.
Okay, please.
Okay, go ahead, Marwa. In Arabic, not a problem. بالعربي ما مشكلة.
طيب أنا بديت في الأحياء الشعبية والمناطق المتطرفة في عدة مناطق الخرطوم. بفتح موقع وبجيب نسوان الحلة كبير السن أو أي فئة يعني بدربهم بشغلهم أوكي بياخدوا نسبة يعني عايز تتدرب تشتغل معي أوكي في المشغل. في ناس بتدربوا بيمشوا بيشتغلوا برا أنا بكون سهلت لهم طريقة المواصلات بكون سهلت لهم المشوار رايحين جايين بفتح في كذا منطقة في كذا منطقة الحمد لله وهسا لسه عندي كمان إنه يعني ناوي إنه أفتح في أم درمان في بحرين حتى في الأقاليم يعني أنا عندي إن شاء الله نية مش أدرب الناس وكلهم مصدر دخلي يعني واسترزقوا مني يعني كله فئة أنا عندها هسا حاليا برضو لما في الجامعة الطلبة الجامعيين لأنه هسا طبعا الجامعات قفلت وبيكون محتاج دخل فبجيب الطلبة فهم بيشتغلوا عندي لحد ما بيجيبوا المشغل المشاغل بتاعتي بيساعدوني بيشتغلوا بيسترزقوا ف يعني ناوية إني لقدام أعمل شغل كرير الحمد لله عندي متجر في الخرطوم بعمل حاجات في المشغل وبيعهم في المشغل
Okay, Wafa, can you translate it?
Okay, she said, I start my business first for myself. And after that, I thought to help other women in the city. They are not meeting in the center of the city. I start to open a gallery art for them and train them how they can design the top. And teach them everything in details about the materials, how they can use it and everything. And they are willing to work with her, welcoming them to her business. If they want to start their own business, she will help them to start their own business. Otherwise, she's opening many small projects in the different areas from the city in Khartoum. She has three gallery arts. And right now, her plan is in the Durman area also, another city in Khartoum state, and also in Bahri, North Khartoum, and her plan for 2020 to open in the region, in the regional areas, the other state in Sudan, to help poor women and rural women in Sudan. And she said she always using social media to promote her business and try to helping others, try to get benefit from everything and anything around her. And she tried to help poor women to support their families.
Okay, okay. Very, very nice and noble move by Marwa. So do you train, how many students are there with you to learn this kind of design? Do you have any batches or any training thing that happening right now?
حصل دربتي طبيعة المشروع بتاعي حصل دربتي ناس كم منهم دربتهم وحاسة إنه بقدر يشتغلوا مع يشتغلوا في نفس المجال بتاعي كده يعني بقدر يشتغلوا I think I missed something from your question, Dr. Shahid.
No, I just wanted to know that is she is still training the other youths.
أنت لسه بتدرب الناس وعندك دارة واصلة في الموضوع هتدربوا تعلميهم البيزنس بتاعك. الصوت يا مروة. الصوت قافل. الصوت يا مروة.
أوكي. أي لسه بتدرب فيهم ولسه حواصل يعني إن شاء الله ولسه كل يوم بشوف إنه يعني في واحدة ما شاء الله اشتغلت كويس بيجيبوا لي شغلهم بشوفه في منهم المشي برا ما قدر واصل بدون راجعين بشغلهم معاي برضو الحمد لله في كثيرين حسب في مصممات عندهم إيسي يعني دربتهم الحمد لله في ناس كثيرين فتحت يعني باب رزق يعني الحمد لله دربت كثير ولسه مستمرة وعايزة واصل يعني إن شاء الله للأفضل
how,
يعني.
how many women you trained كم مرأة أنت دربتيها لحد ياس
والله كتير بذكر عدد معين لكن كتير يعني حاليا أنا معي هسه في المشغل بتاعي الصغير 11 بيت دربتهم واشتغلتهم معي كمان
okay she said she still keep training women and still she's helping them and she they are many graduated from her what could I say? They are in a small institute. They start their own business. If they continue to do the business by themselves, she will help them to promote them to promote them to be well in the business. If they are not, miss the road and they come back to her again, she is still helping them and ask them to join her to work. If they are not continuing their business by themselves. She will keep welcoming them again with her and still she's training. Right now she has batch from 11 women. She's training them and her plan is to continue train others. And she said, I'm happy because there is many top designers right now. She trained them.
Yeah, very, very nice. One thing that I have in my mind that we can use Marwa as a role model that motivate other girls, you know, those who are working, those who are struggling, not only in Sudan, also in other parts of the country. We can have half an hour discussion with Marwa to talk about her, how she has struggled, how she has been successful, you know, to motivate other girls. So we'll connect her again in future and we'll have the special session with the other students, other part of the world, so they can hear her story. She can understand that how the things are, you know, possible. It's like people think that it's not possible to be successful in this kind of situation, even there at the very, very remote areas. So that we can use. And Marwa will be the like very much good role model and she can motivate others. So we can take her help in future if she agrees.
Marwa gal lek Dr. Shahid inno huwa hayitwasal maaki fi almustaqbal ashan ma taqdari تلهم الناس نسوان تانين نساء تانيات إنه تقدري تساعديهم وهو مبسوط شديد بشغلك حتى ما على نطاق السودان ممكن على نطاق برا ممكن تدرب الناس وتوريهم شغلك وتحاولي تساعدي النساء التانيات وتعلميهم طريقة التوب بتاعك حنتواصل معاكي قال لك في نص ساعة في الساعات في الساعات الجاية في 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 المستقبل القريب حنتواصل معاكي أكثر ونعرف أكثر عن طبيعة شغلك. Thank you.
Okay. Welcome, welcome. Thank you.
Thank you, Marwa. So now we go to the next participant. I think that brother that he's left, that Phantom 9, that it shows that Techno Phantom 9.
Yeah, right now we can welcome Ghazi and Nahid.
Yeah.
Yeah, Ghazi and Nahid.
ممكن أطلع يا أوفا؟
Okay, hello everyone.
Yes, welcome, brother.
Thank you. My name is Ghazi and Nur.
Yes, I'm in partnership with my colleague Nahid.
Okay.
But she's having some problem with her phone, and she's also far away from here. Okay. Normally, we don't work on Saturdays and Fridays.
Okay.
Yesterday, we had an exhibition here for what we do.
Mm-hmm.
And we brought all our items to the exhibition area, and she's actually living very close. That's why she didn't join. Her phone is having a problem. That's why she could not join online.
Okay, no issue. No.
Yeah. Actually, my work is about nails and strings. Trying to figure out what I feel most of the time on what I see as a message that I would like to disseminate to other people. And most times it is all about positive vibes, trying to encourage people to have hope in difficult situations. That could be through colors, could be through a meaningful sight or picture, or any given design. I met with Nahid some times back. We had a competition, an online competition in Facebook, in one of the groups. And I participated with my artwork. She also participated with hers. She does watches with the strings, and I do this art pieces with the strings and nails. We hooked up. I was in South Sudan by then. We hooked up, and when I came to Khartoum, we met, and we continued doing our work together as a partnership. I taught her how she can do nailing, and then also the technique of doing the strings on the nail so that she can get the final design. Yeah. Hello, are you getting me?
Yeah, we can hear you.
Yeah. Yes. While I was in Juba also, I trained some people, but you know, such things really require passion, requires you to have passion within you, to have not just talent, because many people sit on their talent, but it needs that drive from within you that you need to do this. And that's what will make you perfected. There are some few young kids, especially girls, because I believe girls, they have that determination, not like boys. Boys, when at an early age, they tend to be so playful. They're not attentive in so many things, especially when it comes to handy things that are done with the hand. I taught one lady, and she was also helping other ladies on how to do this. At first, I would hit for them the nails on the board, and then show them the technique of how to get the picture out of those nails. Because sometimes you see the nail on the board and you will not know if this is really gonna work. But when you put the nails, when you pass the strings on specific nails, while you're having that picture in mind, because actually those nails are just like frames. So you're just putting the strings on the frame so that you can get the final picture. One of them is now perfect, and she does whatever kind of artwork. And the other ones, they're not that committed, and you know, talent comes with that passion, that drive. Maybe they lack that interest, because once they started and they are so hard, they leave it. If you need someone who's persistent, who is willing to really do this. When I came here, I met Nahid, and we also started doing this together. I taught her how to prepare the board, and then hit the nails. It has to be perpendicular. The nails has to be perpendicular, because this is the frame on which the strings are sticked into. so that the shape comes protruding. It's like a three-dimensional design. We did logos to organizations. We did to schools.
Something you have to show, something if you can show with the examples that we can see.
Yeah, sure. Yes. Like this one here. This, okay. This is a sample for peace.
Okay.
Yeah.
هذه اضبطها عديل خدها عديل مع الكاميرا
يا كده مجان This is peace and also I call it one nation. I take the world as one nation. There is no need for racism. There is no there is no need for, you know, saying you are black and I'm white and all those differences. Yeah, this is one. And then there is another one, a symbol that's known worldwide, maybe to most people. Yeah. This is the yin yang. It's about the perfect balance, also about the black and white, the good and the evil. Yeah. And all that. And then there are other designs about peace still. The rainbow.
Okay.
I made this design when thinking about the situation we have here in Sudan.
So this is with this is with the nails and strings, right?
Yeah, this is just nails and strings, as you can see here.
Yeah.
These are the nails.
Wow.
Yeah, and it has to be precise because you need to use some geometry in it so that you can have such a perfect.
So how much time it takes to make this kind of design?
Like this one took me 1.5 hours.
Okay.
Yeah. Actually, we have a board here. This board, I need to stick on it some plastic sheet, the color that is desired.
Mm-hmm.
I use glue to stick it on it, and then hit the nails.
Mm-hmm.
After getting the angles that I need. Like if I'm using 7 colors, that's the colors of the rainbow.
Yes.
I have to measure angles like a hexagon, right?
Yeah.
Then I should know how many nails does each color covers. Mm-hmm. So it took me like 24, 24, 24 each,
mm-hmm.
like that. And then we have other designs like this.
Mm-hmm.
Wow. This is one logo. This is just the logo for a
cat. Yeah, so if somebody wants to learn this kind of technique, how much time it will take to be trained?
Okay, that also depends, as I told you earlier, about the passion the person really has towards art and the patience. This one needs someone who is very patient because while doing it, it takes your time. I'm doing it in that time because I really know how much time I can take in one piece. Yeah, and I love it. I love it when I'm doing it. I never get tired when doing it. Once I start an art piece, I make sure to finish it. And this is the drive that I'm talking about. If you don't have that drive, you will end up, you know, just leaving the piece halfway.
Mm-hmm.
Actually, it's the end product that I wish for. That keeps me, you know, once I start a piece, I want to finish it right there and then. That's why I never get out of it until I'm done with it. Nahid is doing good now.
Mm-hmm.
She's so much interested. And there is one in which we work together, like this one here,
okay.
As you can see.
Yeah.
This one. Yeah. We also work together on this.
Yeah.
Yeah. There are some techniques that she does not know that I taught her recently.
Mm-hmm.
But this one, this requires a different technique than this. Okay. But there are so many techniques about this, and she's really grasping. She's catching up. We have big plans about this. Recently, we made an office. We did not make a gallery yet, but we are in that process. At first, I lacked some basic requirements that I needed for this work, like the strings. We don't have strings here. We have only black, red, green, brown. Other colors are not there. These colors I got from Kenya. I sent to Nairobi. I sent someone there. I knew some few people. They went to the market. They called me through video call. They checked the color. They told me, is it this? So I followed up with them until they sent them to me through the airport. It's really tough here to get some things. You feel like you know your cart. You're not doing what you really expect within you that you can do. You see? There are some limitations, but we are really pushing through because I believe we are not less than anyone outside there. At first, when I first got the idea, I had it when I was in high school. I was good in geometry and all that. I used to make different fascinating figures on the exercise book. And when people take them, they really get mesmerized about these things. And one of the parents of my friends called me home and he told me, you know, you're really talented and you should work on this. And I started, you know, doing that.
So do you get some customer also for this? That have you sold this kind of things?
Yes, I've sold many. I have orders even from Chicago Bulls. I have orders from Australia, from here when I was in Cuba, from Cuba when I came here. I sold like pieces for birthdays. I do gifts, you know, writings. Anything you want to write to your loved one, I write, and then you choose the colors. And I do organization logos. I do different designs, geometrical designs. For now, Nahid does the logos and all that. We do them together, but the geometrical designs require a little bit sophisticated techniques. For that, I do, but she's also catching up. She's doing well. Once she sees me doing one or two, the next time she does with me the same type. However hard it is. So we have market, but people are still not well conversed with it. This is our second bazaar we attended, exhibition, and people are really liking it. They took our cards and I'm getting calls. We have some orders on stand. Once we start the next week, that's tomorrow, we'll be working on few. The only challenge that we have right now is the materials, especially the nails sometimes, and the threads, different colors of threads. I'm also hoping but it cannot work because I tried it, like making dyes.
So I'm telling that, you know, you people have so much talent and things that how do you have any group that you train them in Sudan so they can also earn this kind of money by doing this kind of work, artwork? Do you train some youths, other youths also?
Yeah, this is really my hope. I've been working on that for some time. As I told you, I normally, if I want to train, there are some advertisements that I make in my group, WhatsApp group that I made. I also made some notices that I hang around that if you are interested in this, mm-hmm. you can join. Only like two people joined, and I trained a lady and a boy. And they're so good in that right now. I used to communicate with them and they tell me it's only that they don't have the links to those people who are really interested in that. Because when I was there, I used to go to occasions. We have some salsa group caravan crew group that I used to go to, and you know, it's made up of so many people, and they know me, they have my contacts and all that. This is what they lacked, and I used to connect them. I used to get some orders from there asking me to do this, and I tell them to do it, and they get the cash. You see? But this thing really needs someone who is really interested and someone who is patient. At first, I started with four, but the two did not turn up, because once we started doing this, and it required some kind of, you know, artistic thing. You have to know how to draw at least a bit. And when it comes to using geometry, it really requires someone to be sharp. It requires someone to be some interested into that. It's really very hard to get someone who is interested in math most of the time. And that's why most...
Yeah, so it's very, very encouraging. You know, I'm really surprised to know that lots of this kind of talents are there in Sudan or other African countries also. I have seen, I have met many other people, those who are in the very remotest part of the world, but they are very talented, but they don't have a exposure to the different part of the world.
Exactly.
So that is something, you know, and that is what we are trying to bridge, this kind of gap. And we are trying to bring all those people across the board and at the local level. And I am very happy that we have Wafa as a Sudan chapter, Sudan ASMP chapter. She has done a brilliant job and brought this kind of talent at this kind of platform. And I am thinking, because while talking to you people, you know, I'm really thinking that how I can use your talent to demonstrate other people, to motivate other people also to learn, you know, and they can also be like successful person. They can earn their own money by doing this kind of thing, not only in Sudan, but also because I'm based in Delhi in India. So now I am going to bring all your talent to another innovation lab kind of thing that we'll Good. Bring and we'll try to promote you. And you just make one is 5 minutes video, how you make it, what you make, all the things. I'll request everyone like Asma or Marwa, you, Tagua, and all these kind of people, those who have talent with the product, how you make it and how you can train other people. Just make 5 minutes to 10 minutes of video and share with me. I will edit for you. If you want my help, that I can edit for you. I'll make a tutorial video for you. And we'll try to connect any academy, like those who are doing the innovation, creativity. We can show them if they can take your help in motivating other people in their own academy, and maybe sometime they will be happy to pay you also for your service, you know. That's once right. They will need. So I want you to That's go right. to the next mile, and some poor people also, they can get help from you. They can even, you can volunteer sometime, you can be professional sometime, you know, to not help for yourself but also for the other people, those who are really struggling. And I'm very happy that like this, if you continue, this time we are bringing the youth talent to the world. Next time we'll bring other talent from the Sudan. Definitely government of Sudan will really benefit. They will attract lots of, you know, tourists. They will attract lots of customer for you. And this will really help. And this is nothing, a small thing, because I can see that real change. You know, there are so much hidden, you know, jewel is hidden in the Sudan and nobody knows about it.
Yeah, true.
So I'm very happy.
Thank you a lot. You know, this when I first got the call, I got so interested, and it's unfortunate that I am not here with my colleague, but we are really happy to be invited into this platform, and we would really wish to go, you know, global and help other people. You know, if you are not helping someone else, then you are not realizing true happiness. And this is what I really feel we should do, that what we do is really inflicting happiness on other people and reflecting the inner good within us towards humanity and towards other people and the environment itself.
Definitely. Thank you so much, Ghazi. I'm really very delighted to have you here. And very, you know, I'm very hopeful that we can do the next level, because everyone has the very, very surprising element. I'm really, I can't express that how this is important, especially in this kind of situation, and you can not only improve your chances of earning livelihood, but also you can help others to
other people to improve,
to sustain themselves.
Yeah,
so it can be the game changer. And I will share, I'll ask Wafa to include all those people in that SMP WhatsApp group. Okay, so they can also contribute, they can also motivate other people also, that they should also be like active like them, and they can help each other. And similarly, very soon we'll be connecting and inviting them, you know, to motivate other people. At least half an hour you can give your lecture, how you have turned yourself ups and down, and this one, you know, to motivate others, how they can earn money by being into the remotest part of the world, by learning small techniques, by learning small arts. So these are the things that, you know, we can motivate, and we can keep doing this kind of thing. So Ghazi, I'll just take another participant. If somebody is left, Wafa, then you can connect. If some participants are left, then and then we can conclude at the end.
Yeah, there is two. We couldn't reach them, but yeah, we can see Nejla products, if she has some of her products, the one from Darfur. Nejla, ممكن نشوف منتجاتك لو معاكي. افتح الصوت. عندك منتجاتك معاكي؟ مرحب بك يا نجلاء.
معاي.
اوكي ممكن
سامعاني؟
سامعيني كاي، ممكن تورينا بالكاميرا منتجاتك؟ Can you please show us some of your products؟
يس.
واو سي.
نعم. دي علبة صلصة، علبة بتاعت صلصة فارغة واستفدت منها واشتغلتها بالشكل ده.
توميتو صوص كونتينر. She's changing to Faza.
Wow, very beautiful.
Yeah.
نعم ممكن ندخل فيها الفرش بتاعت الأسنان وممكن نأخذ فيها السكاكين والمعالق في المطبخ أيضا.
We can use it.
نستغلها في مجموعة.
Yeah, for the knives, for the spoons in the kitchen, we can use it, and also for toothbrush.
Very good.
نعم. عندي اللوحة دي.
Okay, it's art.
دي لوحة من النشارة بتاعت الخشب.
Oh, she put me in tight situation.
نشارة بتاعت الخشب.
This a wood leftover. Wood leftover. She making some arts using it.
Very beautiful.
Yeah, and she painting it.
Nice. أما اللي أنتوا شايفينها دي اللساتك اللي أنا اشتغلتها مقاعد دي لسات العربات ولبساها
بالشكل ده عملام شنية نجلاء What are you doing? What are you عملام شنية نجلاء ديل
عملام شنية عملها اللساتك استيقي مع بعض عملها مقعد
Okay, it's two wheels, yeah. Two cars wheel, two wheels. They are, she touching to together and she making it sit.
من هنا بس إنه زول يقعد فيه يعني عادي ناس جاها متينة يقعد فيها زول عادي يعني.
ما في مسند يعني لا.
ممكن أخذ فيها مسند وممكن أقعد فيها كذا يعني. على حسب الزول ما بحبها.
As this as a seat and we can put a cushion. To sit on it.
نعم. نعم. أيضا عندي الشغل الثاني الخاص هذه حلا.
حلا. She making accessories too.
من الأعمال حقني.
Okay, تمام.
نعم. أيضا الإسوارة اللي أنا لابساها اللي أنت شايفاها برضو واحدة من أعمالي اشتغلتها.
من شغل بتاع الإسوارة دي. يعني برودكتس يعني لا.
دي يعني أطقم بشتغل على حسب الطلب يعني إذا وحدي طلبت وأنا بشتغلها يعني عندك دامبلات كثيرة لكن كلها اتباعت يعني فكيتها دي الوحيدة اللي أنا عندي في البيت وشغالة فيها لسه ما خلصتها
The accessories she don't do it regularly she just waiting the orders if there is market she will do it for the customer اللساتك يا نجلاء عندك منهم ثاني؟
نعم. في البيت ما في كلها اتباعت فكيتها يعني فكيتها ما في لساتك تاني أسي
أسين
عندي كمية بتاعت لساتك بشتغلها في الأيام الجاي
or the wheel the car car's wheel because it got sell in the market I think she's doing good business she doesn't have products now with her
very nice it's really very you know interesting thing to see
ايضا عندي اعمال ثانيه كثيره برضو
do you have any question for her Dr. Shahid
no because she is
you know في الشغل دي انا درست فيها يعني
So she's also giving training to other kids in the society.
This في kind المجتمع of... بتاعك يا نجلاء بتدرب الناس حصل دربتي نعم. ناس على الشغل ده بتدربي؟
نعم دربتهم في 5 معسكرات النازحين في معسكر أبويا في معسكر نفاشة في معسكر كساب في كتم في معسكر برقو في محل الطويلة ايضا في معسكر السلام في قريه زمزم
اوكي
دربت لي 730 دارسه
اوكي شي سيد شي تريند وومن ان ذيس بليس كامب ذيس بليس كامب ان دارفور ذا ريفوجي كامبس ان دارفور 5 كامبس شي منشن ذا نيم ابوجا كامب اند لايك 4-5 اي كودنت ميمورايز ات But she trained women in the displaced camp in Darfur. The people they got affected by the war in Darfur. She trained the women how to use this, how to do this kind of products.
Okay, very nice. So now I think that we have covered most of everyone. I think that we have covered every participants today, and we have learned a lot. We have been motivated, and lots of things we came to know. And now I'll request Wafa. To conclude that what we are going to next, you know, to do with this, because I don't want that this discussion to be ended without any result. So we want everyone to have their chance to go to the next level, how we are planning. So you have to plan with them. And I will hear work on the plan that how we can use their talents to showcase to the world one by one, because this was in the group. But next time we'll take their half an hour or 1 hour time to motivate others and to help them that to learn that how things are possible without, you know, even they are in the very remotest part.
Okay. Dr. Shahid بيقول لكم إنه نحنا في نهاية الختام ده عاوزين نصل لنهاية كلنا مع بعض إنه الموضوع ما ينتهي هسي باللغة ده. نحاول أن نطور روحنا ونلهم التانين بمشاريعنا والنقاش ما يقف عين هنا كل زول بموهبته هو شغال لروحه يدرب غيره ونحاول نتواصل مع بعض ونشوف إنه كيف المشاريع دي بتقدر تمشي لقدام حتى ما على مستوى السودان على المستوى العالمي yeah this I think what you said Dr. Shahid And let us conclude this meeting.
Yeah. So at the end, I have shared one link of the ASMP WhatsApp group. Wafa, you can see the chat box. You can copy that one. Yeah, you can copy that. You can share those who want to join there, those who want to, you know, share their own talent and they can motivate. And before that, before ending this discussion, I will request that you please follow up with all the talent, young talents in Sudan, especially Asma, Ghazi, and Tagwa, you know, they should make 10 minutes of video, how they are preparing, and very, very clear voice and video. We'll combine that clip and we'll start promoting their work and we can start talking. And in case if something is there, then we can guide them step by step every time.
Okay, Dr. Shahid Bigul in who has صغير من 4-5 دقائق اشرح فيه كيف اشتغل الحاجات بتاعته دي عشان يقدر الناس التانين يقدروا يشوفوكم وهو حيلم الناس كلها كل المشاركين حاليا حيعمل لهم فيديو كامل او حيخطهم كلهم في منصة واحدة عشان عالميا الناس تقدر تشوفكم كل واحد فيكم يصور فيديو مدته من 4-5 دقائق للبرودكتس بتاعه ان شاء الله نحن بنحاول نساعدكم للمشاريع بتاعتكم دي لقدام، وهو بيجتهد انه يقف مع كل واحد فيكم، وما عاوز انه الميتنج ده ينتهي هنا، الناس تتواصل مع بعض لقدام.
Okay, thank you so much. Thanks, everybody. Now,
can you please take a group picture, Dr. Shahid?
Yes, yes, yes. Only six. We are only six right now.
Oh, yeah. We can take the six. They are serial. We can take the six.
Okay, no problem. No problem. I'll share you on the WhatsApp. This one. And we are, and everything is on Facebook Live. You can see there also. It is already. It was all live broadcast on the ASMP page on the Facebook. There is also all the discussion. Thank you so much once again. I will come back again.
Hello.
Thank you. Asma, okay. If you want to say something.
I just want to clear something that I have started for only 1 year, my work. So I didn't, and I was pregnant at that moment, at that time. So I wasn't really able to be freely moving and trying to search for other people or to train other people or even trying to marketing my work because at that time I was pregnant, a little bit hard for me. And I just, and now also my kid, she's small. I mean, she's still young, three months. But I'm trying to contact with people to know how could we promote ourselves? What is the next step that I should do? Now, because of my situation and my kids are still young, I'm working at home. And as I said, I just started for 1 year my work. So, as I said that, we really want someone to guide us and to make it easy for us to show our products and to share our products and ideas with different and other people who has the same passion and have the determination to achieve their goals and also to help other people. Yeah, I was just started for 1 year and I hope to complete. And by your help and my friends and other people could achieve something.
Yeah, thank you. As I already told, Wafa will be taking care of that. And definitely we are more passionate and more interested in your work also. It's not about the thing that we are going to leave you at this point, because we are working, for not only for Sudan, we are working for across the globe. Those who are really talented, we want to help them. We are it's all volunteer effort. We are giving time. We are bringing people. It's without cost. We are not a commercial people. We just want that everybody should grow on their own and earn their livelihood on their own and help others also. Like we are helping others, they should also help others to grow. So it's like, and Wafa is there locally, to support you. And she is our face in Sudan. Yeah, you have definitely. To be in touch with her, and she is very passionate. I have met her in India. I know that personally, that how she is passionate, how she is committed to her vision and the mission, and definitely will bring the change. You will see that like this we are moving. Everybody, every person is important for us. Those who are interested, they want to use us, utilize our potential. We are very happy to give our time, give our knowledge, share our knowledge and support to them at any cost. Okay, so nothing to worry about. That's why I have shared the link in the group, that join there. We are always welcoming the young talents, and Wafa is the local person there. She will always be there, on any call, and we are always planning. We are already in touch every day, 24 hours we are in touch on the WhatsApp. She again, whatever she has ideas, she just share with me, and immediately we plan and do it. So we are constantly working on that. So nothing. So we'll definitely bring the change. You all are role models for your country. We want that everybody should be together, without thinking about the race, region, geography. Don't think that we are all humans and we have learned from the society. We want to give it back to the society. So that is our mission, that if we have something to give, we have to give. Yeah. And
that's
and,
right.
And then Allah will give us in return in whatever way, we don't mind. But these are the mission we have to be very, very committed. And we are working on that. It has been, I think, more than 12 years for me working for African, especially African youths and African people. Yeah. And we have been working and we are helping them. Then, you know, sitting in India, we are connected to the different part of the world. And we are always available. You know, now in the time of social media, we are not far away. You just, yeah. You can message, you can get the response, you can, you know, talk, anything that is possible, it's not very far away. So now we have to streamline all the things and discuss with Wafa very closely. We have, and I will guide Wafa, you know, in next step, what we are going to do, what, how we can bring, because you are there, that from the environment she was doing that waste products, that is also very unique thing that she is, again, that Tagwa, that she is also doing amazing work. Again, that Ghazi, these are all very important talent. And I want that is why I'm telling them, make 10 minutes of video, what you're doing, what is your product, all the things. I will ask my team to edit it, make it very short to promote your ideas, promote your work, and promote. Even now we are focusing that how to sell your product. After that, we'll promote that how to bring the tourist in your country, because what are the good places to see? What are the historical things to see? Now my next target is to, because you know, once the tourist goes there, they buy the product, they spend money on staying, they spend money on, you know, foods. So lots of things, revenue comes through the tourist and all. So we are also planning into that. We are also trying to connect with the embassies in a different countries, you know, and in government in the different countries, that they should have the training program for this kind of thing, how to take to the next level. So we can help you in the training, special training, if the government wants to have the very country to country training. We are ready to do that. We keep doing this kind of things, motivating. Nowadays we are doing on our own, but definitely when the government involves, then it gives the local support also, big support to you also, you know, that to have the subsidized rates of material, subsidized rates of, you know, infrastructures. So you can get the, you know, better result out of it. So these are all the things we are planning for that. And Wafa is there. And I'm very, very hopeful that we'll take to the next step, not very soon, but definitely within next 15 or 20 days, we'll hear that what we are going for the next. So we'll discuss, I will discuss with Wafa in details, you know, till the time that you keep in touch with Wafa and the team, that what you are doing. First thing, that you just make your own video, 10 minutes of video. That is first and foremost, most important thing to promote. Then we'll see, and each and every product photo and the video should be there.
Okay. Yeah.
So this is all about. Thank you so much, Wafa. And if anything you want to add, you can add. Otherwise, we can conclude now.
Yeah. Thank you, guys. Thank you for those vibrant youth in Sudan. Thank you, ASMB, for having this opportunity. And شكرا لكم يا شباب مطعمين بالحيوية ناس نشطين شغلكم جميل مرحب بكم وشكرا جزيلا مشاركتكم معنا منتجاتكم ومشاريعكم الجميلة. Thank you for joining us, for giving us time from your time. مشاريعكم جميلة, حاجاتكم مميزة, نتمنى إنه الحاجات تمشي لقدام. You have unique projects, it's very beautiful products, and we are wish if we can go together forward to promote your products, to help each other, to train others, to do many things for the youth in Sudan and Africa in general, and so our products are nice products globally. مبسوطين إنه أنتم معانا هنا. شغلك جميل جميل جدا. بنتمنى لك التوفيق والنجاح. Your products very beautiful. Your work very unique. We are here for you, and إحنا معاك. إن شاء الله أي حاجة حتكون جميلة والناس حتشوفك أكثر وشوفوا منتجاتك أكثر. أسمع شكرا لك from Eastern Sudan من القضارف, منتجاتك جميلة ونحن مبسوطين. ASMB welcoming everyone and we are here for you. مروة top designer, Sudanese top designers, شكرا لك, شكرا لمنتجاتك الجميلة, شكرا لزمنك اللي أديتينا له. Anwar, our interpreter, thank you so much. Najla from Darfur, we so happy. مبسوطين شديد إنك معانا. عارفين إنك أنت عانيتي شديد عشان تصلينا. الإنترنت ما كويس معاكم هناك. عرفتي إنه أستاذ وليد تعب عشان يصلك عشان تصلينا. نحن مقدرين وشاكرين اللي أنت عملتيه. Thank you, Najla from Darfur region. She is really strive very much to be in this meeting. Because she is in the region that there is internet not that available for her, and also the coordinator for North Darfur, he give big hand to ASMB Sudan chapter, and thank you for your help, Ustaz Walid. Darfur, you are always in our hearts. You are special for us in T Diamond في قلوبنا, Darfur Diamond في قلوبنا. ونحن دائما معاكم في 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 حاجاتكم وفي شغلكم وان شاء الله نبقى عند حسن ظنكم ونحن معاك يا نجلاء from Darfur we can reach also women in camp to help ASMB willing to work with women in the camps in Darfur work willing to help all women in Darfur all the women that are suffering from the war in that region ان شاء الله نحن معاكم كل النساء العانوا من الحروب في في دارفور شكرا نجلاء شديد ترتيل ترتيل from Blue Nile sorry ترتيل you couldn't reach us you couldn't join our meeting because of the network connection inshallah in our coming meetings you will be with us with your nice product ترتيل ناهد انغازي thank you so much شكرا شديد لانضمامكم لنا منتجاتك يا غازي وناهد جميله شديد inshallah نحن مع بعض ASMB Sudan with everyone here will support you as much as we can. Tenzil from White Nile State, she's using coffee to do some art. Tenzil, she suffered too much to join us until now she keep sending me message, ask me how she can do this. The internet not helping. تنزيل مبسوطين زعلانين حقيقة إنك أنت ما معانا لكن إن شاء الله في الميتينغ الجاي أنت حتكوني معانا عانت شديد عشان تصلنا لكن ما قدرت تصل إنترنت بروبلم برضو شكرا لكم كلكم thank you for all of you ASMB بترحب بكم إن شاء الله نحن مع بعض نحاول نشوف الخطوة الثانية حتكون شنو we are all together إن شاء الله together we'll see what is the next step for us this is just the beginning of our work together. This is just the البداية لنا نحن مع بعض. ASMB in Sudan will stand with everyone and also EWIG organization, EWEGE, Empowerment of Women Through Enterprises and Gender Equality will help everyone. ASMB will stand with us shoulder by shoulder and all of us, inshallah, will help the youth and the women. Dr. Shahid, I'm grateful that you are give us this opportunity in Sudan. Inshallah, we'll show you more good things about what women doing here in Sudan and how we can promote our products and how we can also inspire another woman in Sudan and Africa and also globally. We want you to be with us always. We need you in our coming steps. Inshallah, we'll work together for Sudan and Africa.
Inshallah, we'll do that all together. Thank you so much for giving your time and the new ideas to the world. We'll meet again next week. I think not next week, then in next 15 days, definitely we'll connect with someone with broader guidelines. Thank you so much. Thanks again.